In today's video, I will tell you about the washing machine motor 9 wire connections. I will explain its construction and why these 9 wiring connections are used in this motor. And I have already made a video on this 8 wires motor which will be linked at the end of this video. I will explain the 9 wires connection through its schematic and practically as well. First I am drawing its diagram. It has 2 stators inside the motor, which is something like this. My diagram is not that good, but I will explain you all. The previous 8 wires motor I told you about had a single winding on its north and south poles. But this 9 wires motor has 2 winding on each side of the stator. The second winding is also called auxiliary or helping winding, it is also called compensating winding. And in DC, then it will be called shunt winding. But the situation here is different. Now, all these winding has 8 wire points. Now, these 8 wire points of the windings are joined together and converted to 5 wires. But first, I will make the armature. This armature diagram I am making looks different, but it is easier for me to make you understand through this diagram. Just please try to understand my point. The armature has a commutator. Then the motor has 2 brushes or carbons. First, I will make 2 wires out of these carbons. The next 3 points in this motor the company has taken in such a way. Let me explain to you how, as I will take 1 point from here. The second point we will get from here. We got 4 points now. Now, this winding is not joined with the second stator. So how will it work? The company has joined 1 wire of the auxiliary winding with the bottom end of the main winding on the left side. The main winding on the right side stator, its bottom wire, is joined with the top wire of the auxiliary winding on the left side. Now we have 2 wire points left on the left side of the stator. Now I have extended the remaining stator wires on the left side. These 2 wires are now joined together. Now, these are the 5 wires I told you about earlier. The inside construction of the motor is something like this. I will show you the actual motor as well. Now I will put color coding on these wires. And we'll give each wire a number as well. The common wire connection is blue in color on the left side. And 1 is the number of the wire. The next is the armature wire. Which is light blue in color and its number is 8. The next is also the armature wire. Its number is 9. And the color is gray. The next is the green wire whose number is 10, joined with the winding. Next is also the winding wire. Its color is brown, and the number is 5. This is the construction and the diagram of the motor. Now I have already made the connector wiring diagram to save time. Now let me tell you what things are included in this motor connector. The 1 number has a wire. The 2 number terminal is empty. The 3 and 4 number terminals have TECO installed through which the speed of the motor is controlled and is connected electronically. 1 winding is attached with the 5 number terminal, and the other with the 10 number terminal. The 6 and 7 terminal of the connector has a thermostat installed in them. This senses the motor temperature. And if in case the motor is heating up, it shuts off the motor. And the electronic motherboard does not operate it, which saves the motor from burning. Then 8 and 9 terminal of the connector has the armature. The brushes are installed with the armature. And this is the easiest way to understand the wiring connection of this motor connector. Now I will apply the connections to turn on this motor. It will rotate clockwise. The line and neutral wires will be attached with the 1 and 9 number terminal. The jumper will be attached between the 8 and 5 number terminals. The motor will rotate in a clockwise direction. Now the green, the gray, and the light blue wire over here. The light blue is 8 number wire. The 5 number is the brown wire. I have attached jumper wires between these wires. I have attached a line with the 1 number terminal and the neutral with the gray. Now I will start the motor. See, it will rotate clockwise. I turned it off, as it was rotating with so much speed. So this was rotating in the clockwise direction. Now, this is a different connection to rotate this motor again in the clockwise direction. Install jumper wire with 10 and 9 terminals. Neutral with the 8 number wire. And line wire with the 1 number terminal of the connector. I have installed a jumper wire with the connectors 10 and 9 number terminal. The neutral and line wire on the 8 and 1 number terminals. Now I will power it on. It again rotated in the clockwise direction. Now if you make these connections to the motor, still the motor will rotate in the clockwise direction. I have joined the jumper wire with the 5 and 8 number terminals. And the line and neutral wire with the 9 and 10 number terminals. Now I will pass electricity, and it will still rotate clockwise. Now I will tell you the wiring connections for the anti-clockwise rotation. Join jumper with 8 and 10. Line and neutral with 9 and 5. I have connected the jumper wire with the 8 and 10, as you can see it. Line and neutral wires with the 5 and 9 terminals. I will pass electricity through it. See it rotated anti-clockwise. Now, these connections are also for the anti-clockwise rotation. 8 and 1 has line and neutral wires. 5 and 9 have a jumper installed. See, I have installed the jumper with the 5 and 9. Line and neutral with the 1 and 8 number connectors terminal. See, it rotated anti-clockwise. For running the motor anti-clockwise, you can make these connections as well. Connect neutral with 10 number terminal and line with 8 number terminal and the jumper wire with the 9 and 5. Now I will start the motor for the last time. See, it rotated anti-clockwise. Now I have explained to you the wiring connection for the 9-wired washing machine motor. I hope this will be helpful for you. Click on the left video to watch the 8-wired motor connections. And subscribe. It's free. Thank you.